in a bog by a tree. It was a pretty nasty place, but he was happy because ogres like nasty. On his 7th birthday, the little ogre's parents sat him down to talk, just as all ogre parents had for hundreds of years before.
Listen, son, you're growing up so quickly. Growing up bigger by the day.
Although we want you here, the rules are very clear.
Now you're seven. So it's time
to go away. Your mama packed a sandwich for your trip.
Papa packed your boots in case of snow.
You're gonna make us proud, no backing up allowed.
Just keep walking, and you'll find somewhere to go.
It's a big, bright, beautiful world with happiness all around.
I don't care. step forward. Pinocchio the puppet.
I'm not a puppet. I'm a real boy.
That's your passion pod down there. Fairy godmother. I'm here. Three blind mice.
Oh, I'm dumped on a swamp. Man, I'll tell ya, sometimes being a fairy tale creature sucks pine sack.
Stand up to that no good flim flammer Farquaad.
Tough enough, you don't even know me.
I always dreamed I'd get a happy ending. It was foretold on my horoscope.
What's his wish?
Has officially worn out. Now I'm gonna go talk to this Farquaad guy and get you all off of my land and back where you came from. Something to shake those goons. Guess it worked because
I hear voices over here. Come on, let's get them. No! It's hideous.
Well, that's not very nice. It's just a donkey.
Step aside, ogre, and let us at him.
Why? What did he do?
I don't want to die. I don't want to die. I don't want to die.
He's a talking donkey, a freak of nature, as are you, you unsavory beast. By the order of Lord Farquaad, I am authorized to place you under arrest.
Under arrest, eh? Sorry. This is the part where you run away. And don't come back!
Can I just say? That was incredible! Man, they were tripping over themselves to get away from you. I liked that.
Oh, good, I'm glad. Now why don't you go celebrate your narrow escape with your friends?
But I don't have any friends.
Now there's a shocker.
So you lost or something?
No, I'm just trying to find the quickest way to Duloc.
Oh, Duloc! I know Duloc. You gotta let me show you the way because I am like a GPS with fur.
I'll be fine on my own, thanks.
But nobody's fine on their own. Not when you look like we do. Hey, didn't you hear what I said? We gotta join forces, otherwise they're gonna lock me up, and I cannot go back in a cage. I don't know if I mentioned it or not, but I did 6 years in solitary for impersonating a piñata. Whoa. That was really scary. And if you don't mind me saying, if that don't work, your breath will certainly get the job done.
Listen, little donkey, take one look at me. What am I?
Really green.
No, I'm an ogre. You know, grab your torches and pitchforks. Doesn't that bother you?
Nope.
Really?
Really, really.
Oh.
Man, I like you. What's your name?
Shrek.
Shrek, huh? Well, you know what I like about you, Shrek? You got that whole, I don't care what anybody thinks of me thing going on. I like that. I respect that, Shrek. You all right.
Oh, good. Goodbye.
Hey, 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 you gotta let me go with you. You don't know what it's like to be considered a freak. Well, maybe I do. That's why we gotta stick together.
No.
Don't speak. Just hear me out. I might surprise you. I'll be a friend when others despise you. Don't roll your eyes. Stop with the moping. You need a pal. My calendar's open. I'll bring you soup when you get congested. I'll bail you out when you get a
things get scary, and I've seen it. When it gets hairy, don't let me go.
Muffin Man.
The Muffin Man?
The Muffin Man?
Yes, I know the Muffin Man who lives on Drury Lane.
Well, I heard it from the Muffin Man.
The Muffin Man?
The Muffin Man!
She heard it from the Muffin Man.
Can I go now?
No, you haven't told me where she is yet.
I can't.
Tell me.
I won't.
Tell me, or...
No! Not the bunnies! Let me get to the bunnies!
Then tell me where she is!
I'll tell you. She's a day's walk from here, in a dragon-guarded castle, surrounded by hot boiling lava.
Ooh, well, that sounds dangerous.
You want a princess or not?
Oh, go on.
In the highest room, in the tallest tower, you'll find a fiery princess named Fiona. Oh,
Princess Fiona. She sounds perfect. Except for that whole dragon and lava thing. I'll have to find someone else to go.
Big surprise!
I will make Fiona my queen, and Duloc will finally have the perfect king. Captain! Round up your men, summon the citizens, and bring this cookie to the swamp.
Swamp? That's a thing to get?
Thelonious, tell the royal coiffeur I need to get my hair dressed. We're going to get a queen.
The rules are very simple. Whoever spots a horse and cart along the road, punch buggy.
Ow!
Fun, right?
No! What kind of an insane game is that?
Haven't you ever been on a road trip before?
No.
Man, you need to get out more because punch buggy.
Ow!
I got you with that wagon full of hay over there. See,
don't care if you do that one more time.
See, that's another reason you need me around. Who else is gonna fill you in on all the fun stuff you missed out on? You may not know it yet, but you are one lucky ogre to meet up with.
Punch buggy.
Mother of repentance.
Monkey cart at 3 o'clock. You know, you're right. That was pretty fun. Shall we play again?
No, that's okay. You win. Maybe we should move on to I Spy or the license plate game or something that isn't going to put me in a body cast.
Okay. Lord Farquaad's castle.
Didn't I tell you I'd find it?
It's a bit much, isn't it? Don't you think he might be compensating for something? Ah, forget it.
Good afternoon, everyone, and welcome to the Duloc Fetch a Princess Festival. The show's about to begin!
Hey! Oh. Hey! Let's find this Farquaad guy and get out of here.
Ooh, I want to stop in the gift shop to get a head on a stick.
We are not stopping for a head on a stick.
Welcome to Duloc, such a perfect town. Here we have strong rules, let us lay them down. Don't think we're staying by, here we'll get all the fun. Duloc is a perfect place. Please keep off of the ground. Your shoes like your face. Duloc is a perfect place. And here's the man who made it happen. The towering colossus of Farquaad.
Oh, it's you. What a terrific surprise. Once upon a time, this place was infested. Freaks on every corner. I had them all arrested. Hey, naughty, 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 no. If you had a quirk, you didn't pass inspection. We all have our standards, but I will have perfection. And so, things are looking up here in Duloc.
Let's take a look.
Things are looking up here in Duloc.
He likes to cook.
A model that amazes, a player with 7 faces.
out here in Duloc.
We're looking out
in Duloc. The ladies all look swell. The men are so dashing. Thanks to my new dress code.
And so,
no one from the gutter into luck.
Keep singing it.
Embrace the cookie cutter into luck.
We're all the same.
The outside is enormous when you can shout.
Come for us!
Yes!
Creatures.
Newsflash, Ilgar. But that oozing mud pit is actually within the province of Duloc, and therefore under my jurisdiction.
Now look here, Halfpint.
Wait a minute. Wait a minute. Oh, this is too perfect.
What is?
You're so big and hulking and wonderfully expendable. People of Duloc, we have our winner. Congratulations, Ogre. You've been given the honor of embarking on a great and noble quest.
But we're already on a quest.
To get my swamp back?
Yes, and you've nearly accomplished it. All you need to do now is just one more simple little task, and I'll hand you the deed to your swamp.
And what exactly is this simple little task?
Oh, Walter! The dossier on Her Royal Highness. People of Duloc, their queen is on her way.
Things are looking up. Things are looking up here in Duloc.
agreeing to go on this quest. What do you know about rescuing a princess?
I've read the stories.
And I've read the sports page. That don't make me a hockey player. What's it say about the princess anyway?
It says here she likes pina coladas and you're getting caught in the rain.
She sounds fun, but
it also says she's been locked in a tower since she was 7 years old.
Well, that's sad. All alone in that tower since she was 7 years old. 7 years old, 7 years old, 7 years old.
You are so weird.
Thank you.
23.
I know it's today.
I know it's today.
I know it's today.
For your information, there's a lot more to ogres than people think.
Example.
Okay. Ogres are like onions.
They stink.
Yes. No.
They make you cry?
No.
You leave them out in the sun and they get all brown and start sprouting little white hairs. And...
No. Layers. Onions have layers. Ogres have layers. Onions have layers, you get it? We both have layers.
Oh, you both have a layer.
Yes.
You know, not everybody likes onions. Parfaits. Everyone likes parfaits, and they have layers. Have you ever met a person and you say, hey, let's get some parfaits, and they're all like, oh, no, I don't like no parfaits. Parfaits are delicious.
I don't care. Ogres are not like parfaits.
Parfaits may be the most delicious thing on the whole damn planet.
You know, this may turn into the longest day of my entire life.
Feel that warm breeze?
Aye.
Came up so suddenly.
That's because we're on a bridge.
Oh, I didn't even notice. What bridge is this?
The bridge to the Dragon's Keep.
Oh, the bridge to the Dragon's Keep. So that intense heat I'm feeling coming up under my hooves?
That would be the Lake of Molten Lava.
Oh, the Lake of Molten Lava?
Oh, donkey!
A rickety bridge over a lake of molten lava!
You'll be fine, just keep walking! And whatever you do, don't look down!
I'm looking down, Trevor, looking down!
Oh, for the love of Pete!
I am frozen with terror!
Donkey, just take a step!
I can't!
Look into my eyes!
I can't!
Grab my hand!
Yes.
Now walk!
Okay, but don't let me go. Don't let me go.
I won't let you go. I won't let you go. That'll do, donkey. That'll do.
Shrek, was that you? Man, you gotta warn somebody before you just crack one off. My mouth was open and everything.
Donkey, believe me, if I had just cracked one off, you'd be dead. It's brimstone.
Yeah, right. Brimstone. Don't be talking, it's the brimstone. I know what I smell, and it wasn't no brimstone, and it didn't come from no stone, neither.
Well, hey, this'll come in handy. Hope it's fireproof. All right, you wait here, I'll be back in a bit.
Wait here? You mean by myself?
Unless you'd like to come slay the dragon and rescue the princess.
Oh, no, I'm good. Waiting is fine. But hurry back! Man, this place is creepy.
You don't know the half of it. Sorry.
Hey, it's a new guy! We've had a new guy a couple years!
Shrek, come back! There are inside-out people! Don't want to wake her up.
She gets really mad.
What are you talking about? Who are you people?
We're knights. We came to rescue the princess.
Just like you.
None of us made it, though.
We're the lucky ones. Everyone else she incinerated.
What? I'm out of here.
That's what we thought.
Oh my God, oh my God, oh my God.
That's what we did. Said.
Another day inside my keep. I get no rest, I get no sleep. Cause when I start to count my sheep, you come around.
I'll come back later then, it's okay.
I don't want to stay dead and lock my doors, but still you come.
Yeah.
great, I got one of the snoozers. Wake up. Wake up!
Are you Princess Fiona?
I am. We're waiting a knight so bold as to rescue me.
Good, that's great. Now let's go.
But wait, Sir Knight. I have long awaited this day, and I would just like to know as the name of my champion.
Shrek.
Sir Shrek. I pray you take this favor as a token of my gratitude.
Oh, great. Thanks. So, where's the door?
There is no door.
What do you mean there's no door? How do we get down?
Why, the same way you got up.
The same way I... Oh, come on! I just... All righty then, let's go!
Now hold this on, Sir Knight. Don't you want to savor this moment? It's BFR first meeting, after all. It must be a wonderful and romantic scene.
Jeez, it's like I'm a crackpot magnet.
This is how a dream comes true. This is how I picture you climbing in to rescue me. This was always meant to be.
Okay, that's great. Now hop on!
This is how the scene must go. He's standing there, the light just so. Then you smile and gaze at me. Take my hand on bended knee. Bended knee.
Bended knee!
Oh, sorry. And though we've only met, somehow I always knew it would look like this when dreams come true. What the heck, what are you doing?
Well, I have to go save my ass.
Slow down a bit. Shouting girls are delicate. I've only followed this my whole life long. Now you're doing it all wrong. Down on the proceed of wit. That's why every story sits. Riding over rough terrain. Past the dragon you have slain. You have slain. You have slain.
It's on my to-do list.
What?
No, 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 get away. This is unwanted physical contact. I do not give you permission. Donkey?
Dragon! Just relax and take a breath. Hope he doesn't burn to death. Never mind the protocol. He's your hero after all. Tra-la-la-la, what's past is past. Tra-la-la-la, I'm free at last. In the end, the princess always gets her man. And underneath that helmet, I bet he has a tan. My champion, my savior, my dashing Romeo. He has a talking donkey, that part I didn't know.
Wait a minute, look. It's just like in the book. They're fighting over me, as it's meant to be.
Pink ponies, happy sky. Pink ponies, happy sky. Oh my god,
we're gonna die!
And where would a brave knight be without his noble steed?
All right, I hope you heard that. She called me a noble steed.
She picked up a steed.
Well, Sir Shrek, the battle is won. You may remove your helmet.
No.
Why not?
I have helmet hair.
Oh, please. I would just look upon the face of my rescuer.
Oh, no, you wouldn't.
But how will you kiss me?
Kiss you? That wasn't in the job description.
Maybe it's a perk.
No, it's destiny. A princess is rescued by a brave knight, and then they share a true love's first kiss.
With Shrek?
Mm-hmm.
You think that Shrek is your true love?
What's so funny?
Oh, well, princess, let's just say, I'm not your type, okay?
Of course you are. You're my rescuer. Now remove your helmet.
Look, I really don't think that's a good idea.
Just take off the helmet.
I'm not going.
Take it off.
No!
Not!
Okay. Easy. As you command, Your Highness.
You're an ogre.
Oh, what? What are you expecting, Prince Charming?
Well, yes, actually. No. I'm supposed to be rescued by my true love, not by some ogre and his pet.
Well, so much for noble steed.
You're not supposed to be an ogre.
Look, princess, I was sent here to rescue you by Lord Farquaad. He's the one who wants to marry you.
Oh, well then why didn't he come rescue me?
Good question. You can ask him that when we get there tomorrow.
Tomorrow? Oh my gosh, sunset.
So?
I didn't realize it was so late. We didn't make camp.
Camp, but you've just escaped.
Yes, and I found the whole ordeal quite exhausting. I need to find somewhere to rest immediately.
Well, that is too bad, because we're going to keep going.
I need to find somewhere to camp! Right now!
Very well. There's a cave right over there.
Shrek, that's no place for a princess.
No, it's perfect. Well, gentlemen, I bid thee good night.
You want me to read you a bedtime story? Because I will.
I said good night!
She seems nice.
By day, one way, by night, another. This shall be the norm until you find true love's first kiss, and then take love's true form.
And this is what I realized. If we escaped a dragon, then we could do anything. Man, I could be a steed. Or I could work the crusade circuit if I wanted to. I could even be one of those horses that pulls those wagons full of beer. I'd need some hair extensions on my ankles, but I could do it. What do you want to be?
I don't want to be anyone.
Just for fun, though, who would you pick?
I wouldn't.
But if you had to?
Donkey?
Like if a guy had a sword at your throat and was like, look now, you can't be an ogre anymore. Pick something else. Then who would you pick?
I would pick that guy up and hurl him into a tree.
Man, you are no fun at all, you know it. Is this what it's gonna be like when we finish rescuing the princess? Us sitting around at our swamp all day doing nothing?
Our swamp? Donkey, there is no our. There's no we, there's me and my swamp. And the first thing I'm gonna do when I get back is build a 10-foot wall around my land.
You cut me deep, Shrek. You cut me real deep just now. What's your problem anyway? What do you got against the whole world?
Look, I'm not the one with the problem with the world, okay? It's the world who always seems to have a problem with me. You saw the way the princess reacted. That's how it always is. They take one look at me and they go, oh, look, it's a big, scary, stupid, ugly ogre. They judge me before they even know me. That's why I'm better off alone.
But you know, Shrek, when we first met, I didn't think you was just a big, stupid, ugly ogre.
Yeah, I know.
So there's really no one else you'd rather be? Thank you.
guess I'd be a hero with sword and armor clashing, looking semi-dashing, a shield within my grip. Or else I'd be a Viking and live a life of daring while smelling like a herring upon a Viking ship. I'd sail away, I'd see the world, I'd reach the farthest reaches, I'd feel the wind, I'd taste the salt and sea, and maybe storm some beaches. That's who I'd be. That's who I'd be. Or I could be a poet and write a different story, one that tells of glory and wipes away lies. To the skies I'd throw it, the stars would do the telling, the moon would help with spelling, and night would dot the eyes. I'd write a verse, recite a joke with wit and perfect timing. I'd share my heart, confess the things I yearn, and do it all while rhyming. But we all learn, but we all learn. An ogre always hides, an ogre's fate is known. An ogre always stays in the dark and all alone. So yes, I'd be a hero, and if my wish were granted, life would be enchanted, or so the stories say. Of course I'd be a hero, and I would scale a tower to save a hothouse flower and carry her away. But standing guard would be a beast, I'd somehow overwhelm it. I'd kiss the girl, I'd take a breath, and I'd remove my helmet. We'd stop and stare, we'd speak of love, we'd feel the stars ascending. We'd share a kiss, I'd find my destiny. I have a hero's ending, a perfect happy ending. That's how it would be. A big, bright, beautiful world, but not for me.
Stays in the dark.
So yes, I'd be a hero, and if my wish were granted, life would be longer. Of course, I'd be a hero, and I'd stand in a tower to save a hot house.
Thank you.
The sun's so big, it hurts my eyes, but really, that's okay. A brand new day with things to do, so many plans to make, and a six cups of coffee, so I'm really wide awake. I've always been a morning person, a morning girl.
Funny little mushrooms down by the stream.
No, of course not. I'm just happy that today is a new day full of fresh starts and promises. And I'd like to apologize for my behavior yesterday. We clearly got off on the wrong foot, and I'd like to make it up to you.
You would?
Yes, you did rescue me after all. So I gathered some berries for the trip and made some roses.
Oh my God, look at these! They're beautiful, Princess. Aren't they beautiful, Shrek? Bite one, look. Get away from me!
You'll learn to love them, I promise. Now, lead the way.
So, Princess, do you often frolic with rats?
And what if I do?
Oh, I don't know, Princess. German-fested vermin, just not exactly what I expected.
Well, maybe you shouldn't judge people before you get to know them. So, that's all my groom to be. Lord Farquaad, what's he like?
Well, let's just say this, Princess. Men of Farquaad's stature are in short supply.
Really? Yeah, but he is a little intimidating.
Well, he must be.
And yet very good at small talk.
What are you guys doing?
Oh, well, nothing, Princess. We're just saying you might want to lower your expectations a little bit.
Yeah, like 3 feet or so.
All right, yuck it up. It doesn't bother me, not today. After a lifetime of misery, things are finally starting to go my way.
Oh, a lifetime of misery. Right, okay.
You chuckled.
Hmm?
When I said lifetime of misery, you chuckled.
Did I?
Yes.
Look, I'm sure it was very difficult living in a dragon-guarded town.
It was.
I'm sure.
All right, then.
Although, it must have been nice to have a roof and a cozy bed, which is more than I had when I left home.
You're not actually comparing yourself to what I endured.
What? I'm just saying you don't corner the market on unhappy childhoods.
There are things you don't know. You know, about me, about how rough I had it.
What, you run out of shampoo a couple times?
I mean about my life.
In that cushy tower of yours.
Cushy? Are you kidding? I am nothing in that tower. Fighting boredom by the hour. Princess lonely, walking circles. I had only Bear Churchill's army caught a hot plate and a chamber pot, and every morning I would boil it. No choice, I had no toilet, just a view of devastation. Now one window isolation in my bedroom, and very little headroom. 20 years I sat and waited. I'm very dedicated on walls of danger, and luckily those walls were padded. So,
you think so? Well, that's a sad story, but I've heard better. I'm just saying, A for effort, X for play. Sad to see a princess suffer, but I had it rougher. Like that time a mob with torches burned my bridges. See the scorches? Yeah, you're just whining. I had a flaming hiney. As I fled, I had to wonder if I were torn asunder, would an ogre go to heaven? Did I mention I was 7? So, I think I got you beat. I think I got you beat. Yeah, 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 yeah. I think I got you beat. I think I got you beat.
I got you.
Oopsie. Well, better off than in, I always say.
Princess Fiona, I am Lord Farquaad. What do you think? No, you're right, too formal.
600.
Fiona? Farquaad, but you can call me Maximus, as I've no doubt you will. Whoop.
No, too smutty. But soft, what light through yonder window breaks? It is Fiona, and Farquaad is the son.
My lord, we've just received word. Princess Fiona has been rescued. She's on her way.
On her way, Raw. She's on her way, and so am I. My fairy tale princess. I always said I'd be queen king. And now, look, the last adorable piece to my master plan. Oh, that reminds me. How are the wedding preparations coming?
All in order, my lord. We've booked the cathedral and the band.
Although I do wonder if you wanted to maybe invite your father.
But what?
Your father, my lord.
You mean that horrible little man who tried to keep me down my whole life? That mal-tempered monster? That vile little grunt who abandoned me in the woods as a child?
Well, he did have his reasons.
Lackey, please! My father simply couldn't accept that I wanted nothing to do with the family business. That lowly, dirty family business.
My daddy was a miner, so he wasn't much around. Foraging for diamonds, a life spent underground. Daddy didn't talk much, he barely said hello. He simply muttered, "Hi-ho!" And off to work he'd go. Daddy was grumpy. My mama was a princess who left her crown behind. Daddy was her true love, so mama didn't mind. I never knew my mama, but she could have been a queen. She married way beneath her. Beneath her knee, I mean. Oh, Daddy's bed was lumpy, so Mommy couldn't sleep. Daddy built a new one, so tall and so steep. 25 mattresses she slept upon, one night she rolled over, and Mama was gone. So Daddy was grumpy. Left me, left me.
bed.
Oh, you abandoned me in the woods as a child, Danny. Well, I crawled out and up. Oh, if you could only see me now, Danny. I'd invite you to the wedding, but you have to be this tall to get in. To the races, men! Just for fun. And I will get my kingdom, and I will get a queen. Once I get that crown on, you will get the guillotine. And I'll punish you, Daddy, because I'm all grown up and bigger than you'll ever knew. You're gonna pay, Daddy. It's any day, Daddy. I'm off to work.
Marshmallow and chocolate, you use squirrel gizzards and mulch. Oh, they just melt in your mouth.
Oh, I think I need to sit down for a minute.
Oh, no, no sitting. We need to get the princess to Duloc.
No, Shrek, I was just thinking I might not get another chance to try one of those Snithers.
Oh, you eat one and you may not get a chance to do anything.
Zip it, donkey.
Couldn't Duloc just wait until morning?
Morning?
Why not? I've spent my whole life without true love. Let's... one more night.
All righty then, I'll find us some dinner.
I'll get the firewood.
Oh, sorry. You're going that way. Oh, here, I'll go. Hey, should we just go together?
Yeah.
All right.
There's something going on around here. I've been watching, and the signals are clear. A nervous laugh when she brushes his skin. The sweaty palms, the big adult grin. With a giggle and a flip of her hair, I smell the pheromones in the air. Making goo-goo eyes over their food. They need my help here in setting the mood.
Oh, you don't believe love is blind? Well, I've got some friends who think otherwise.
Reach for her hand, maybe give her a kiss. She's waiting for a move to be made. You gotta, 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 gotta. You gotta make a move.
A little bit nutty, right?
I guess I'll be dining a little differently. I do love tomorrow night.
You know, maybe you can come visit me on the swap sometime. I'll cook you all kinds of food. Swap toad soup, fish eye tartar, you name it.
I'd like that.
Frick, I know you can't hear me right now, but if you could, I'd want to say a few things to you. I am in your corner, buddy, but you've got to tell this girl how you're really feeling deep down. You might not get another chance, so just go on. Princess,
here we go.
Yes, Shrek?
Hi,
Oh, it's your color.
Well, I was...
Oh, I can't take this.
I was wondering. I was wondering.
Spit it out.
Are you going to eat that?
Man, what is wrong with you? You got to make a move. You got to shift in the gear. You got to buckle down and give me the world. The city's set right out of the book with a sunset and a beautiful girl. So you got to, got to. I was afraid of the dark, too, you know, until... In a way, I'm still afraid of the dark, sure, protect it.
I'm sorry, but I really have to go.
Oh, all right.
Good night.
Good night.
No, sir. I'm sorry, but I did not call this way to end up with you and your body odor, just so you cannot walk away like that.
What are you talking about?
Hey. I'm an animal, and I got instincts, and you two are obviously digging on each other.
Oh, you're crazy! I'm just bringing her to Farquaad.
So you don't have any feelings for her at all?
Look, even if I did, and I'm not saying I do because I don't, she's a princess, and I'm,
an ogre.
Yeah,
an ogre. She needs to know, well, where are you going to get more wood? Before your fire dies.
Break the spell and make you beautiful.
But you know,
you're kind of an ogre, and Shrek. Well, you got a lot of common.
Shrek.
Yes, you knew all this?
No! No, he cannot know, and you can't tell him. Not a word. No one must know. Promise me you will tell him. Promise me.
All right, I won't tell him. But you should. Man, I know when this is all over, I'm going to need a whole lot of serious therapy.
Princess, Well, how's it going, first of all?
Oh, you're good?
Oh, I'm glad.
Oh,
good for me, too? I'm okay. I picked this flower. Right over there is where it grew. And I don't really like it, but it made me think of you. Because it's pretty. And what I'm trying to say is you are also pretty, but I like you anyway. So please accept this flower with its petals and a stem, which represents my feelings and tell you how. Man, I'm in trouble. When the words fail, what will I do? How will she know how I feel? Words fail, will I fail too? Do I have snowball's chance? Are my prospects just too grim? I spent my life stuck in the mud. Now I'm crawling out on a limb. She'll know what I mean. If words fail, she'll just take my hand. She sees me like no one else does. If words fail, she'll understand.
deed, and the deed has been put in your name. Now, step aside before I change my mind. Forgive me, Princess, for startling you. I am Lord Farquaad.
Forgive me, Lord Farquaad, for I was saying a short farewell.
Oh, that is so sweet, but you don't have to waste good manners on the ogre. It's not like it has feelings.
No, you're right. It doesn't.
Princess Fiona. Beautiful. Fair. Perfect. Flawless, Fiona. I ask your hand in marriage. Will you be the perfect bride to the perfect groom?
Lord Farquaad. Excellent. Oh. Nothing would make me ask
this. I'll start the plans for tomorrow. We then.
No! I mean, wait! Let's get married today, before sunset.
Oh, anxious, are we, Captain? Ride ahead and tell them it's a code red. You're right, sooner is better. Let's hurry, there's so much to do. We'll be married by sunset.
Ooh. Oh, man, there's not a lot of good night's sleep. What I miss.
Take it down, never take it down.
you of all people would recognize a wall when you saw one.
Well, yeah, but the wall's supposed to go around my land, not through it.
It is around your half. See? That's your half, and this is my half.
Oh, your half?
Yes, my half. I helped rescue the princess. I did half the work, I did half the booty.
Back off.
No, you back off.
Stubborn jackass.
Smelly ogre.
This is my swamp.
There you go again. My. Me. Well, guess what? Now it's my turn, so you just shut up and pay attention. You are mean to me. You insult me, and you don't appreciate anything I do. You're always pushing me around or pushing me away. You're so wrapped up in layers, onion boy, you're afraid of your own feelings.
Oh, yeah? Well, if I treated you so badly, then why did you come back?
Because that's what friends do. They forgive each other.
Oh, go away!
See? There you are doing it again. Just like you did to Fiona. And all she ever did was like you, maybe even love you.
Love me? She said I was ugly, a hideous beast. I heard the two of you talking.
She wasn't talking about you. She was talking about herself, somebody else.
She wasn't talking about me, then who was she talking about?
Uh-uh, no way. I ain't saying anything. You don't want to listen to me, right? Right.
Donkey.
No.
Fine. I'm sorry. I'm sorry, okay? I guess I am just a big, stupid, ugly ogre. Can you forgive me?
Hey, that's what friends are for, right?
Right. Friends?
Friends.
So, what did the princess say about me?
What are you asking me for? Why don't you just go ask her?
Ask her?
You want to be a hero? Now's your chance.
Donkey, the wedding! We'll never make it in time!
Now what kind of noble steed would I be if I didn't have a plan? Follow me!
Today to bear witness to the union of our new king and queen. And as the warm glow of the setting sun lifts our hearts, so too...
Excuse me, could we just skip to the I do's?
Right, well then, do you, Lord Farquaad, take Princess Fiona?
I do.
And you, Princess.
I do!
I thought you might. Well, with the power vested in me, I now pronounce you king and queen.
Stop the wedding!
Shrek?
What is he doing here? Really, it's rude enough just being alive when no one wants you, but interrupting a wedding uninvited.
Fiona, I need to talk to you.
Now you want to talk? Well, it's a little late for that, so if you'll excuse me.
But you can't marry him.
And why not?
Because he's just marrying you so he can be king.
That is outrageous! Fiona, don't listen to him!
He's not your true love.
And what do you know about true love?
Oh, this is too precious. The ogre has fallen in love with the princess. Oh, good lord. Guards, take this abomination out of my sight.
No! Let's just hear what the ogre has to say. It might be worth a laugh.
Oh, you are too evil.
You heard her, ogre. Express yourself with as few grunts as possible, please.
Okay. It's a big, bright, beautiful world with happiness all around. It's peaches and cream. If a dream comes true, it's a big, bright, beautiful world. Possibilities everywhere. If true love is blind, maybe you won't mind the view. I know I'm not the handsome prince for whom you've waited. I don't have a fancy castle and I'm not sophisticated, a princess and an ogre. I admit it's complicated. You've never read a book like this, but fairy tales should really be updated. It's a big, bright, beautiful world. Is now I'll let it in. I'll tear down the wall and clear a spot for two to be with you.
No, actually, you won't.
What are you doing here? You
insolent beast, though. I'll have you drawn and quartered. I will have order.
You are beautiful.
I waited all my life, lived it by the book. Now I know that's not my story. You take me as I am, love me as I look, standing here in the my glory. I am sweetness, I am ratty, I'm a princess, I'm a fatty, I'm a mess of contradictions in a dress. I am sassy, I am sappy, when I'm with you I am happy. This is my story.
You laugh at all my jokes, even when they're rude. You don't mind that I'm not classy. We make a perfect pair, radiant and rude. So in love and much you gas, we are ogres, we are scary, we are donkeys, we are hairy. We have bold and brand new stories to be told. We will write them, we will tell them, you will hear them, you will smell them. This is our story.
And that is how the little ogre came to live on the swamp, with a beautiful princess.
Aww. And his best friend.
And his best friend!
And a ginger puppet! And a green handsome puppet!
Okay,
I'm married!
get me.